In this lesson, we will explore how the block editor works in practice. In practice means that we're going to write a post, and we're going to use blocks to build it. Some blocks are essential for every kind of post, like paragraphs, headings, and images. Others are more specific, like a list or a pull quote. We won't tackle all available blocks in the video because that would take ages. If you're looking for information on a specific block, we advise you to check the reading materials. One more thing before we start. In these screencasts, we are using the latest version of WordPress and the default 2020 theme. If you're using another theme, what you see on this screen may be different than what you see on yours. Still, the blocks and their settings generally work in the same way, so no worries there. Let's begin. In this post editing screen, the first block, which is there by default, is the title block. That's where I will start, and I will add my title here, Yoast Diversity Fund. Right on the title, I have the option to start typing or add a block. If I start typing, or paste a text in this case, that means I will automatically use the paragraph block. Naturally, you use the paragraph block when you want to add text. That's exactly what I need right now. I have my text right here, and I will copy and paste it. To continue building this post, I will need to keep adding new blocks. Each paragraph of the text will be in a new block. And that is also true for any new images, videos, or anything I want to add to this post. It will all need to go in its own block. So that's what I'll do. I'll add my second paragraph in a separate block. Now, I would like to add an image between these two paragraph blocks. So far, I was just adding text without choosing which block I wanted to use, because the paragraph block was there by default. If I want to do something other than writing some text, I will need to find and add the appropriate block. In this case, I need the image block. Because I want to add the image between the two paragraph blocks, I need to hover my mouse over the middle spot in one of the blocks until I see the plus sign appear. When I click it, I get the list of all the available blocks. Under the Most Used Blocks heading, I see that there is an image block. If I want to add it, I just need to click on it. But right now, I want to show you an even quicker way to add a block. I'll click on the first paragraph, put my cursor at the end of the text, and then press Enter. To find the image block, all I need to do is type in a forward slash, followed by the block name. Like this, forward slash image. I see different options appear in a drop-down box. I need the image block, and so I select that one. The image block is now in my post, but I still have some decisions to make. That is, I need to determine how to add the image. I can upload it, add it from the media library, or insert an image from the URL. In this case, I want to add an image from my computer, so I'm going to go with the upload option. I click the upload button, I find and select the image from my computer, and I click open to add it to the post. As you can see, the image block automatically comes with a caption field below the image. Let's see, I'll write something like Yoast cares for diversity. Now the next thing I want to add is a subheading. Again, I'm going to need a block for that, the heading block. So I will type a forward slash and then heading to find the right block. And now I can add my text. Learn more from Yoast Evolk. Now, there's a video on YouTube with Yoast, our chief product officer and founder, where he tells more about the diversity fund. So let's add it to the post. You probably know what's coming. Yep, the forward slash and then video. And as you can see, there's more than one option. I can pick video, but I can also pick YouTube. Both options work fine. Let's check them both out to see whether things work differently. Let's start with the video block. Just like with the image block, there's three ways of adding your video. You can upload a video file from your computer, select one from the media library, or insert from the URL. Since I want to add a video from YouTube, I will need to insert from URL, which means that I will paste the URL of the video in this input field. Let's try the YouTube block now. I'll click on the plus icon and look for the embeds heading. Here they are. If you want to add content from any of these platforms, you can use one of the blocks available here. They're quite a lot, right? Right now, I need YouTube, so I select it. And now that it's in my post, I can paste the link to embed the video. The result is the same as the other video. The only difference between these blocks is the way I added them. Other than that, they are exactly the same. But hey, now I have two identical blocks and I don't want that. How can I delete one of them? No problem. Just select the block you want to get rid of. Click on the three dots in the toolbar and click Remove Block. So what's next? Yeah, I need to inform my readers about eligibility and how to apply. So let's do that. I add a new heading block and add the title Who Can Apply. There's a list of criteria people need to fulfill to apply, and I want to show them in a list format. So I need a list block. Let's add that with /, and type in list, and add the text here. And I'll now repeat the same thing once more. To round it up, I could add a nice quote. Maybe it will inspire people to apply. But how do I do that? Our friend the /, has been very useful so far. But there's another way to add blocks. So let's see. I'll click on the plus within the post. You'll notice the plus is also in the toolbar. The difference between these two is that if you use the toolbar plus, you can also see a preview of the blocks. So let's go with that. Look, there are so many blocks to choose from, and they are divided into different tabs or headings. So far, we've used many of the common blocks, and I showed you the embeds. Let's see what the formatting tab holds. There is a pull quote block here. If I hover over it, I can also see a preview. So what do you know? That's exactly what I need. I select the block, and it now is in my post. I add my text here, and add Yoast's name in the citation. Of course, I want to let people easily apply for this fund, so I need a button. Let's go to the layout elements, where the button block lives. Click it to add it to the post. And now, I can add the text I want to have displayed on the button, something like Apply Now. Let's also get the link to the application and paste it here in the input field. In WordPress, you can also add some widgets to your posts. You can see which ones under the widgets heading of the blocks list. Right now, I don't need any of these, so I will not add anything. But it's good to know that you have those options as well. So, now you know that there are many blocks you can use, depending on what you need. And the best part is that it's super easy and super quick. I have to admit, this post doesn't look perfect yet. But that's all right, because there are plenty of ways I can edit it and make it even better, which you will see in the following videos.